Hi, I'm Jason Morrell, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to go from this to this. So the first level has 1A, and the following headings say B, C, and D. The next major heading will say 2A, followed by B, C, and D as standalone letters. Now it's a little bit tricky, but here's how it works. You may have noticed I don't have a level 1 anywhere. It starts at level 2, followed by 3 level 3s. Same over here, except they're called headings. And there's a reason for that, and that is that I'm going to have a level 1, but hidden. And that's going to control the number that we see here, which is going to form part of the definition for level 2 numbering. That's what I'm going to show you in this video. Don't forget, you'll find some downloadable resources, including this working template, in the description below. So let's dive in. Let's maximize this window. Now the first thing I'm going to do is to add a level 1, which is going to be hidden. But it's going to serve a purpose in our multi-level numbering to enable us to combine two numbers in that first step that we saw before. I'm going to highlight the text, go to the multi-level numbered icon, and choose Define New Multi-Level List. It's already expanded, which is good because we need this linked level to style bit a bit later on. So first, level 1. I'm just going to set this to a 1-2-3 style, but we're not going to use it anywhere on the document. It's going to be hidden information that gets picked up in level 2. Because it's hidden, I also don't need to worry about the aligned at and text indent at figures down here. But I do want to link it to heading 1. Now level 2, this is where it gets a little bit tricky. So first of all, let's wipe this out. We're going to include the level number from level 1, and this will be the first time we see it in the document because obviously level 1 is hidden, followed by a dot. And here's a little trick. If you press Control Tab, it actually puts a tab marker as part of this definition. Now that'd be lovely if it worked all the time, but unfortunately Word is very buggy and it only works once. So it works the very first time out, but as soon as you try and use it again, it actually removes the tab character and replaces it with a space, which is very, very annoying. But I'll show you the whole process and I'll show you what happens and then how you can address it. Now the number style for this level is going to be the ABC. And in the example we saw before, that was followed by a closing bracket like that. In terms of positioning, it was aligned at 0. So it's the number sat on the left margin. That's the 1 number in this case. And we're going to indent it at 1.5 centimeters. Actually, let's make it 2.5 centimeters. Because by the time you've got that first tab jump in there, it's a little bit bigger than it normally is. And then level 3, we're going to, again, wipe this out. Now level 3 is continuing the ABC, so we're going to use the ABC style by itself, followed by a bracket, but we're going to start it at B. And then we're going to align the number part, that's the ABC part, at 1.5 centimeters. And again, the text indent is going to be at 2.5 centimeters, so that all the text following the A, B, C, or D is always starting at the same point. Now, even though it's not to scale, you can kind of see what's happening here, and you can see that the numbering behavior is correct. So let's just finish by attaching each level to a style. So level 1's already connected to heading 1. Level 2 needs to link to heading 2. And level 3 to heading 3. So let's click OK and see what we look like. So here's what we have. Now everything's currently at level 1. So let's go to level 2 and indent it by 1. Let's go to all the level 3s and indent it twice. And you can see that the flow is correct, but the positioning is currently incorrect. And that's fine. A couple of small adjustments, we can fix this. Now the first thing is, on this level 2, the tab jump, or the default tab positions, it jumps every half inch. So basically what it's doing is it's jumping too far here. So what I'm going to do is to modify the heading 2 styles, go to the Format button and click the Tabs, and set two tabs here. Now 2.5 is fine. That's the one that it picked up from the multi-level numbering definition. So I need to set another one for 1.5 centimeters. Let's set it and click OK. And you can see that that's now fixed up that positioning issue. Now to prove this works, let's just copy this whole block, copy it down here. You can see that the hidden level, it's not hidden yet, but we're going to hide that in a minute. But level 2 has numbered correctly. It's got 2A followed by B, C, and D also. So the last piece of the puzzle is to modify the heading 1 style definition. And again, we're going to go to the Format tab and we're going to choose Font. And there's a tick box here called Hidden. Click OK and click OK. So now heading 1 is still in play on the document. It's still performing its function, but you don't see it. So if you do need to see the hidden information, the Show Hide button here does that. That reveals all the hidden stuff within your document. So let me just hide that again. Now I did mention, as I was building that numbering definition, that there is a glitch. It's a clear bug with Microsoft Word. And let me show you why. I'm going to save it, close the document, close Word altogether, and reopen it. So here it is, reopened. Now look at the distance between the number and the A on both of these examples. So when we built the numbering definition, we inserted a control tab, which inserted the tab character as part of the definition. But unfortunately, Word does not retain that. What it's actually done is it's replaced the tab character in the definition with an ordinary space. So you just have to live with that. There's no way around that. I haven't found a solution in all my years of research. So the best you can really do is to take the level 3 definition. We're going to align it in line with the A for the B, C and D. And the level 3 text, or whatever text is there, we're going to make it line up with the level 2. So here's what we do. Back in the multi-level numbering icon and define the multi-level lists, we're going to go back to level 3 and we're going to change the indentation here so that it starts at, let's say, half a centimeter. I'm just guessing here. And text indent now can be 1.5 centimeters. Doesn't need to be as far across as it was. And we click OK. And that's kind of close, not quite close enough. Maybe a 0.6 instead of a 0.5 would do the trick. But you get the idea here. You can also see that our level 2 here is indenting still to 2.5 centimeters. So let's quickly go back in again, change the definition. So on level 2, we're going to change that 2.5 to a 1.5. And of course, if you want to increase the gap for everything, you can do that here as well. But that's fixed up the issue. So you get something that's workable. It takes a little bit of trial and error to get the positioning and spacing correct, but that's the method. So we've got a hidden level that's controlling the number that you see the very first time you see it, which is the 1.a, the 2.a, and so on. And then you've got a standalone letter for the level 3. So I hope that's answered some questions for you and given you some inspiration and some ideas. If this video has helped you, please share that in the comments below. I love reading the comments that people drop. It's always appreciated. I'll see you in the next video.